You know, we can have an endless debate on the question of have you lost your salvation? Can you lose your salvation? I don't even like to phrase it like that because it gives you the idea. It's like a pen. I misplaced it. Where did I leave my keys? Our salvation is not something little like that. You just lose it. The question is, can I forfeit my salvation? I would encourage you to do this. Rather than focus on that question, and I believe the answer is yes, you can forfeit your salvation. Let's look at God's promises to us and major on that. And he says this in Romans, the 8th chapter. At the end of the chapter, he says this, "For I am sure," Paul writes, "that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God and Messiah Jesus our Lord." God will not force you to stay in his house. God will not forbid you from leaving. God will not say that you cannot walk away from him. He will not take away your freedom of choice. You can choose to deny him. You can choose to walk away from him and pursue a life of sin and say, "I reject you as Lord," and he will not force you to stay in the home, and he will not force you to walk in obedience. But unless that's your heart and intent, and you intend to deny the Lord and walk away from him, don't major on that. Instead, if you want to follow the Lord, you're his child, major on the promises that he promised to keep you. So be warned if you think you can walk away from the Lord without consequences, but be encouraged. Nothing can separate you. Be encouraged. There is no force outside of you that can separate you from the love of God. That is how tenacious his love is set on you. Major on that.